Oi, tudo bem? Aqui é a Luciana da Street Smart Brazil. If you've been following my Portuguese lessons for a while, you know that I love colloquial expressions. Idioms are necessary for good communication, especially if you want to sound natural. This Portuguese lesson will teach you four Brazilian colloquial expressions with the word pé. Well, pé means foot. Now let's go to the expressions. Here's the first expression, estar de pé. Estar de pé. It means that an event or a plan is still on, it's confirmed. I'll give you examples. All the sentences in Portuguese and all the translations in English are on the blog post for this lesson, and I'll put a link to the blog post in the video description. Let's say that you and your friend Malu have plans to spend the coming weekend away at the beach. You planned this a while ago, so as the weekend approaches, you text Malu and you say: E aí? O nosso fim de semana na praia está de pé? E aí? O nosso fim de semana na praia está de pé? So what you're asking is: Hey, is our weekend at the beach on? And here's Malu's answer. Com certeza. Te ligo de noite para combinar os detalhes. Com certeza. Te ligo de noite para combinar os detalhes. So she's saying, for sure, I will call you tonight to plan the details. You will often see this expression with the word ainda. So here's an example, using the same situation as before. E aí, o nosso fim de semana na praia ainda está de pé? So now what I'm saying is, so is our weekend at the beach still on? So that's what ainda adds to the sentence, the sense of is it still on? One more thing. You may know that we often drop the first syllable of the verb estar in spoken Brazilian Portuguese. So what you will hear more often is actually: E aí, o nosso fim de semana na praia ainda tá de pé? So instead of está, I will say tá. The next expression, bater o pé. And when I say it all together, here, bater o pé. So it is to demand something, to insist on an idea, to not give up on your position on an issue. Let's look at an example. Imagine that your cousins, Amanda and Felipe, had a fight a while ago and they have not talked to each other in a while. You're chatting with your friend Ana about the situation and you say: Eu já disse mil vezes para o Felipe que ele devia pedir desculpas para Amanda. Mas ele sempre bate o pé, dizendo que não deve desculpas a ninguém. Ele é muito teimoso. So I'll translate it and then I'll read it in Portuguese again. Well, this is saying I've already told Felipe 1,000 times that he should apologize to Amanda, but he insists. That's the expression bater o pé, insists that he doesn't owe apologies to anyone. He's very stubborn. In Portuguese again. Eu já disse mil vezes para o Felipe que ele devia pedir desculpas para Amanda, mas ele sempre bate o pé, dizendo que não deve desculpas a ninguém. Ele é muito teimoso. Another example. A gente vai começar a procurar um apartamento para comprar. Eu vou bater o pé que o apartamento tem que ter varanda. So I'm saying we're going to start looking for an apartment to buy. I'm going to insist that the apartment needs to have a balcony. Again in Portuguese. A gente vai começar a procurar um apartamento para comprar. Eu vou bater o pé que o apartamento tem que ter varanda. Here's the next expression, com o pé atrás. Com o pé atrás. Literally, it means with a foot behind. So imagine that I'm not walking confidently. I'm keeping one foot behind as a precaution. So what it means is I'm feeling suspicious. I'm feeling hesitant. I'm feeling cautious because I don't trust the situation or the person. Let's look at an example. Marcos nunca entrega as traduções no prazo. Por isso, agora estou com o pé atrás para trabalhar com ele. So I'm saying Marcus never delivers the translations on time. So now I'm hesitant to work with him. I'm being cautious, so I'm keeping one foot behind. Again in Portuguese, Marcus nunca entrega as traduções no prazo. Por isso, agora estou com o pé atrás para trabalhar com ele. Another example. Meu chefe ficou com o pé atrás comigo depois que ele descobriu que eu estou procurando outro emprego. I'm saying my boss got suspicious of me after he found that I'm looking for another job. In Portuguese again. Meu chefe ficou com o pé atrás comigo depois que ele descobriu que eu estou procurando outro emprego. And the last expression today, largar do pé. Largar do pé. It means to leave someone alone, to stop bothering someone. Here's an example. Faz meses que a Ana e o Pedro terminaram, mas ele não larga do pé dela. So I'm saying, it's been months since Ana and Pedro broke up, but he will not leave her alone. Again, in Portuguese. Faz meses que a Ana e o Pedro terminaram, mas ele não larga do pé dela. Our last example. Pedro, você precisa largar do meu pé, por favor. So Ana is saying, Pedro, you need to stop bothering me, please. Just leave me alone. Pedro, você precisa largar do meu pé, por favor. Thank you so much for watching the video. I would love if you would subscribe to the channel. If you liked this lesson, click like, make a comment, ask your questions in the comments. This really helps us. It means a lot to me. Well, you know, the best way to make sure you remember these expressions and you're able to use them correctly is to practice them in real life conversations. You need to intentionally create opportunities to use the expressions. To learn a language, you need to speak the language. I keep saying that. So we offer one-on-one Brazilian Portuguese lessons via Skype. You can learn with one of our tutors from anywhere you are. So visit streetsmartbrazil.com, book a trial lesson, and see how we can help you advance your Portuguese. Muito, muito obrigada. Tchau, tchau.